JRA 501 here. Coolant record-keeping troubles at San Onofre Nuclear Power Plant. Published November 9th, 2012. Updated November 10th, 2012. Written by Pat Brennan of the Orange County Register. New problems came to light late this week at the shuttered San Onofre Nuclear Plant, including coolant found in the oil system of a backup generator and a record-keeping error stretching back to 1985. New problems came to light this week at the shuttered San Onofre Nuclear Power Plant. None of the problems posed a danger to plant workers or the public, plant operator Southern California Edison and a nuclear regulatory spokesman said on Friday. Coolant problem was discovered October 23rd during maintenance work on a backup emergency diesel generator in one of the plant's reactor units. Coolant was found in the generator's oil system. The problem was reported to the NRC on October 30th. Edison officials said the cause was being investigated. An Edison statement released Friday said that while the investigation has not resulted in any evidence of tampering, that scenario has not been ruled out. Edison spokeswoman Jennifer Manfrey said that was among the possibilities being checked out. The record-keeping problem was revealed in the recent NRC inspection report for the plant. Inspectors found that information about a storage area known as the South Yard facility, where radioactive pipes, valves, and other low-level radioactive waste was kept, had not been included in safety analysis reports as required from 1985 until June of 2012. No problems were found with the storage area itself or the way the waste was being handled, said Victor Drix, NRC spokesman. The issue was purely one of record keeping. They're required to maintain documents that accurately reflect current plant conditions and procedures. They failed to do that here. While the record keeping lapse was listed at severity level number 4, Drix said that is the lowest of the severity levels, the highest being 1. And that it was considered a violation of very low safety significance. So, the plant operator was not cited. So, why would they bother to include safety analysis reports if they're not going to get cited? And they're considering this a very low safety significance. So in other words, we just got to mention it. You didn't do it. Bad boy. Business as usual. Do whatever you want. The inspection report showed another violation listed as green and of low safety significance, and that also did not result in the operator being cited. This was a failure to correct weaknesses or deficiencies that are identified in formal critiques of drills or exercises, according to the inspection report. Obviously, we take all these issues seriously, and we are addressing all of them, Manfrey said. Both of San Onofre's reactors have been offline since January. A small leak of radioactive gas prompted the shutdown of the Unit 3 reactor January 31st, but inspection showed unexpected wear among thousands of steam generator tubes in both reactors. Inspections traced the wear to design flaws in the steam generators, 2 for each reactor, installed between 2009 and early 2011 in a $671 million operation. Edison has proposed to restart the Unit 2 reactor, where the wear was not as extensive as in Unit 3, at 70% power, then to shut it down again after 5 months to determine whether it is working properly. The lower power is expected to stop the vibrations that caused the unexpected wear. The NRC has said reviewing the proposal and deciding whether to approve it could take months. Edison and the NRC will meet to discuss the restart plan in a public meeting in Dana Point, November 16th. Unbelievable. And from what I read, Edison is pushing, and I'm going to make another video on this, but Edison is pushing to restart Unit 2 reactor by the end of the year, this year. God help us, and God bless.